time for the match game, Hollywood Squares, our with Gallagher. And our special tribute to Leave It to Beaver. Stars of the match game, Hollywood Squares, are Gene Rayburn and John Bowman.
Thank you.
What are you singing, John?
I'm singing the theme from Leave It to Beaver. Did you see Richard Deacon run?
Yeah, I heard the building rumbling.
He must be wanted.
You ought to see him fall.
Yeah. Listen, would you join John Bauman and me in greeting our stars of Leave It to Beaver?
Hit it.
Hello, stars. And Gallagher.
And Gallagher. Oh, yeah. Leave It to Beaver.
I didn't mean to leave you out, Gallagher.
Well, you left me out of Leave It to Beaver.
We think we're going to adopt him, though, so it's okay.
Really? Listen,
pretty
you know,
guy.
I watched you make your entrance on the monitor backstage.
They didn't do
and
that.
You look just like that guy as a kid. Didn't he look just like, what's his name on that show as
Andy
a kid?
Right?
You're right.
Right?
Somewhat like.
Of the Leave It to Beaver cast, may I see a show of hands of those of you who are still in show business? One, two.
Very slowly.
Very slowly. What are you doing in show business?
Well, I do all sorts of things. Hopefully, I'll be doing some movies this year.
Right.
And I do a lot of personal appearances.
Right.
I work in radio a lot. I go all over the country and do different morning shows. So I work quite a bit. Have a good time.
Good. Now, what are you doing with your life?
Well, believe it or not, Gene, I'm a policeman right here in Los Angeles.
You're a cop?
Yeah.
No
and
kidding.
May I say, that's a nice-looking suit you're wearing.
Thank you very much. What sort of policing do you do? Are you in a squad car or whatever?
No, I ride a motorcycle.
You ride a motorcycle?
Mm-hmm.
I think that's fascinating. How long have you been doing that?
14 years.
Good for you. Good for you. Congratulations on that. That's a wonderful thing to do. Now, let's greet our two civilians over here, Virginia Watson and Debbie Sullivan.
Yay!
How do you do, ladies? Let's get acquainted, Virginia. Tell us about you.
Well, Gene, I'm a native Californian and a graduate from the University of Southern California, where I earned a dual major's degree in political science and broadcast journalism, with a minor in being a cheerleader. And at the present time, I'm an aspiring actress.
Well, you're very pretty.
You
can play the part in my book, Virginia.
I'd love to.
Good luck here. Now, Debbie, tell us about you, please.
Not quite as exciting. I'm married, I have four children, and I work full-time as a registered dental assistant.
Exciting.
Four children, I think that's exciting. Wow.
That's a lot of teeth.
I mean, it's tough for a 16-year-old mother to be a mother of four children. You don't look a day over 16, if I may say so, Debbie.
Thank you.
All right, good luck to both of you. Let's not begin. I'll talk to you first. Here on the match game, each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of the ding-a-lings as you can. The one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner and go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Now, I will push it one more time. Oh, you see, it was a thumb that did it. That does it. There's a thumb. Now, you won the toss. You go first.
I'm going to try my luck with A.
All right, Virginia. Little Rodney Rotten is really rotten.
How rotten is he?
Good,
lumpy. Very good. Isn't that a good bunch out there? I'll tell you how rotten he is. When he found a tube of super glue, he glued his puppy to a blank. Oh, Rodney Rotten. That veil you wore at the entrance,
Was
that an American flag?
Yes, it was.
You're a very patriotic fellow, Gallagher.
Well, actually, I just like to stick stuff in my hat.
Oh. I Someone was saying Gallagher is certifiably goofy.
Ah, nah.
I would have to agree. Okay, Virginia. Little Rodney Run is really rotten. When he found a tube of super glue, he glued his puppy to a blank.
To a porch.
To a porch. Why do you say porch?
Is that... Where's that, Porsche?
A Porsche.
Porsche.
To the porch.
To the porch. All right, to the front porch or to the back porch or something like that. What do you say, Gallagher?
I say that he glued it to a kitty.
A kitty, a good response. Glued his puppy to a kitty. That must have hurt
a lot of fun.
What'd you say?
Well, I thought maybe a fire plug that he, you know. Hey, put it right there.
That's a good one. Kenny, you got a good one?
Hey, listen, I'm with Beef, you know.
All right.
Yeah, the kid's got it.
Nice little artwork, too. Okay, John, where did he glue his puppy? What did he glue his puppy to?
I'd like to take my time allotted to me on this show to ask Ken, a.k.a. Eddie Haskell, to write at this moment, just for me, a command performance, Call the Beave a Squirt. Will you do it? Can you do it?
Listen, John, that's easy because he is a squirt.
I feel much better now. I've been waiting for 2 days for that.
Right.
You couldn't punch me on your best day. You always.
I agree with both of those squirts. Fire hydrant.
Fire hydrant. Yeah. Okay, no, Frank.
Well, in Palm Springs, we also call them fire hydrants.
You do. Okay, Richard.
You frequently have a dumb blonde in this position.
That's right.
You got a dumb bald in this
okay,
position.
Okay, what does a dumb bald say?
A doggy door.
Oh. A doggy door. Couldn't think of anything.
Will you come up here and do it?
Glue that answer to your head, Richard.
It's a lot easier when you're sitting out there or at home, let me tell you. Hey, did you hear they open up a new McDonald's at the zoo?
No.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Their specialty is blank McNuggets.
Oh, we at the can't zoo. Say that, though.
Blank McNuggets.
Frank? But I'm slow. That's okay.
All right. Debbie, did you hear they opened a new McDonald's at the zoo? And their specialty is blank McNuggets.
Monkey
all McNuggets. Right. Debbie wants to know is, did anyone think of Monkey McNuggets? We will poll you one at a time. Gallagher.
Mac Monkey McNuggets.
Aha. That's the New York Jets.
Yep. Okay, Jerry.
It had a nice sound. Monkey McNuggets.
Aha, two. What do you say, Ken?
John, I can't call him a squirt when he's coming up with such good answers.
Well, the upper tier is unanimous. Debbie now has three. What do you say to this, John?
Well, and you can call me a squirt because I said lion.
Lion McNuggets.
A squirt?
Lion.
Thank you.
McNuggets?
Well, hey, it was the first thing that came into my mind. Put this in your head.
That was dumb. Lion.
Lump. What does a lump say?
Well, first of all, I mean, Monkey McNuggets, they don't make it. I mean,
like
you
it.
Have to think big if you ever want to get anywhere in life.
God knows you do.
Absolutely. Yeah. Elephant McNuggets.
Uh-huh.
It's got to be better.
No. Right.
Well, I wrote a cookbook, and I said ostrich egg McNuggets.
Uh-huh. Very fancy.
Oh, don't turn into a mob.
It's no change for
they
that.
Got your number, Richard. All right. The 3-0 in Debbie's favor. That's the end of round one. Round two coming up in a moment or so. Please watch this first.
Light fight. Call now.
Round two coming up. Here we go. Debbie, you're ahead. You have to go first.
I'll pick A, please.
A it is for Debbie. Let's see. The upper tier lays out because you matched Debbie in the previous round, so that's for you guys only, okay?
That means we're stupid.
That's right.
Yes. You guys
you said it.
Nothing new for you.
Ding-dongs
is the word.
One nurse said to the other, these two nurses are talking, you see. She said, I think that new surgeon used to be a bartender. He just pulled out a lady's blank with a corkscrew.
I'm sure glad I don't have to play this one.
You don't like this one? Yeah. But... Sometime before the end of the week, you're going to tell us if there's any other name other than Gallagher in your life?
No, on just your the birth- one. Actually, that's two names joined together at the L's.
You mean your name is Gall?
Uh-huh. Gallagher.
Gall?
Lager.
Lager. Oh, Gall.
Gallagher.
It's French.
Lager.
Uh-huh, it's French for no front name.
All right. Ready, John?
Here I was known as Gallagher Cleaver. Isn't that right?
One nurse said to the other, I think that new surgeon used to be a bartender. He just pulled out a lady's blank with a corkscrew.
Appendix.
Appendix is good. How do you feel about appendix, John?
I feel reasonably good about appendix, Steve.
There it is. Yeah! What's more, you spelled it right. Okay.
There's a lot of choices.
Oh, sure.
Appendix isn't bad. I was thinking of some good ones, but I think I finally wound up going with appendix.
There you go.
Nice going, Lumps.
Yeah.
All right, Richard, do you still have your appendix?
That's none of your business.
Okay.
And that's the dumbest answer I've ever seen.
We thought it was pretty
just
good.
Just match two people.
Appendix.
That's right.
Oh. Oh.
Now, Virginia, you have two chances to catch up. Rounds two and three. Let's see if you do. Pretty Paula is so pretty.
How pretty is she?
Men throw themselves at her feet.
Oh.
Ugly Edna is so ugly.
How pretty is she?
Men throw blank at her feet. And everybody ready down there. Put in the slot, Frank?
Oh, yes.
All right. Virginia. Pretty Paula is so pretty, men throw themselves at her feet. Ugly Edna is so ugly, men throw blank at her feet.
Men throw dirt at her feet.
Dirt. All right. Let's see if we get that over here. Dirt. What did you say? Dirt. Gallagher.
I didn't put dirt. I put no pest strip. What do you
No pest strip.
Sure.
I got a little laugh.
Insect repellent. That's
Gallagher
okay.
Cleaver strikes again.
That was a tough one for me, and I figured that maybe they would be stomping on her feet with their shoes. Well, I couldn't think of anything else.
That didn't get a laugh.
Well, you're the comedian.
Now,
you know.
No pest shoes.
Oh, that's I like that one.
All right.
That was terrible.
That was bad?
I'll do better next time, guys.
Gee, Mr. Rayburn, this was certainly a very difficult question.
Tell me about it.
I think they throw others at her feet.
They throw other bodies at her feet. They throw others. Men throw others at her feet.
Apparently it was rather
they
difficult.
Throw each other at her feet. I guess it was a tough question. What have you got, John?
I have an answer that I happen to love. Horse manure.
All right. One possibility.
Don't
boo
him.
To each his own, you know.
Yeah. Don't boo him. Why?
No, that was the best answer.
So far.
I think so, don't you, John? I said manure.
Okay.
Money! Absolutely.
Oh, shut up, Clarence.
Ooh, I thought you were going to say something else, Daddy.
So he's his dad. He's his dad.
Mr.
Right.
Rutherford and Lumpy Rutherford.
Shoes.
What did you come up with that one?
Okay.
I thought your answer was very good.
I knew you'd like that one.
Round two, Debbie is ahead, 6-0. One more chance, Virginia, to catch up. Let's see if it happens after this.
Answer?
That's 800-279-7300.
Here we go, a third and final round. Debbie has matched everyone, so she's going to lay out. Normally the winner goes first. Virginia, you have a choice of A or B.
A, please.
All right, let's see what A says. The Fat family finally married off their daughter, Fatima.
Wait. Didn't it say no fat questions?
No fat questions.
I understand it's in their contract.
No fat
Ken was the only one that can answer fat questions.
Hey, give me the fat questions.
I'll get all the fat questions over here.
That goes that fat question. I'll add live one.
Jane.
I'll add live one.
I mean,
one.
You know.
There was this family, they had a girl who was rather obese, and they...
Really? How
they,
obese was she?
She was
That's
so
okay.
obese, they named her Fatima.
Oh!
She weighed 14 pounds when she was born. They called her
more.
Fatima. You see, it's a little play on fat. So I'll ad-lib the rest of it. And,
Fatima Rutherford.
Hey!
Fatima, when she grew up, she was so fat, they...
How fat?
Some of you are asleep. When she grew up, Fatima was so fat.
They've got a lot of...
They nerve. Had to grease her just so she could squeeze into the blank. Wait a minute. This is at the wedding ceremony when they married off their daughter, the Fatima. Oh. Fatima's so fat, they had to grease her just so she could squeeze into the blank. Did you understand that?
Yes, I think so.
I'll give it to you one more time straight. The Fat family married off their daughter, Fatima. Fatima's so fat, they had to grease her just so she could squeeze into the blank.
Let's see. How'd you do?
Good. I got the right answer.
Just sit down and be quiet, Lump.
All right. Here we go. All right, Virginia. The Fat family finally married off their daughter, Fatima. Fatima's so fat, they had to grease her just so she could squeeze into the blank.
Into her wedding gown?
Into the wedding gown. All right. Now, you need 6 wedding gowns to stay in the game and achieve a tie, and we're going to find out right now if that happens. Did you say... Well, you have to show and tell now.
I know. Do you think I said wedding gown? Do you think I said get grease all over all that lace? No, I said church.
Church is a good answer. Very good. So that means Debbie Sullivan wins the game. What the rest of you have?
Dress. Dress right here. Frank. Come on, Jack. Right there.
We all have the right answer.
Right over here, for what it
means. You guys shape up.
Now, Virginia, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
You're a very beautiful lady. Good luck in your aspiring career. We'll send some gifts your way to Virginia Watson. Come over here. Congratulations to you. Ah, here comes the rest of the furniture. Time now to switch to Hollywood Squares. We'll bring on 3 more celebrities here who'll make an entrance. I'm going to switch places with John Bauman, who'll be hosting Hollywood Squares. We've got lots more excitement coming up here. Hurry back.
A member of our studio audience will receive a Sylvania video disc player. With laser technology, you may enjoy brilliant color pictures and special effects furnished by Sylvania. It's time for more of The Match Game. Hollywood Square. Power. With more of our tribute to Leave It to Beaver. With Barbara Billingsley as June. Rich Corral as Richard. Jerry Wilde as Judy. And taking over, the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bauman.
We'll be right back.
I was zonked.
And now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Square.
Oh! She's a dental assistant, see? And I have a very big mouth, see? Okay, welcome to the second half of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, and I have with me a dental assistant, Debbie Sullivan, who just drilled her opponent in the Match Game competition and is now ready to take on a returning champion in the game of Hollywood Squares. Also, we have to say hello to 3 brand new celebrities, all from the fabulous Leave It to Beaver show. We have June Cleaver, a.k.a. Barbara Billingsley, and Judy, who is really Jerry Wilde, and Richard, who was cleverly Richard Corral. Good to have you all with us. Richard, a.k.a. Richard, you've been doing something pretty interesting in the last few years since you left the Leave It to Beaver show. Can you tell us about it?
Yeah, well, I've been associate producing the Laverne and Shirley and Happy Days, having a real good time. That's been a lot of fun, Other side of the camera,
Terrific. Okay, well, tell the fans that Bowser said hello, okay? And in the meantime, let's you and I go over here and get ready to play Hollywood Squares. Here we go. First, we will reacquaint ourselves with our defending champion. Her name is Cindy Charbonneau. This is, I believe, her 4th day, right?
Yes.
You would know because you were returning with a total of $34,475. Not bad.
Just remind us a little bit about your life to date before you were a rich woman.
Well, you know, my name is Cindy, and I work in administration in a large engineering corporation. I have 5 children, and I'm happily married and enjoy being a working mother and housewife.
Mm-hmm. And I'm sure you enjoy winning money right here.
Nice,
you got
too.
Another chance today. Let's play Hollywood Squares.
5 children and 4 children, John?
Yes, Lumpy, that's
they
right.
They are busy. Yeah.
Ooh. Okay, now we're going to play this game until you hear the time's up bell. Whoever is ahead at that point is, of course, our winner. Goes on to play Supermatch for up to $30,000. You've won that once. Okay, our first game is worth $100 plus $25 for every square that either of you should capture. Our champion always gets to start. That is you, Cindy Charbonneau. Pick a star and let's go.
Beaver, please.
I'm ready.
The Beaver.
We're ready. Let's go.
Beaver, according to the merit report,
The merit report.
Okay. Yeah. Do most American men believe you can fall in love at first sight, or are they skeptical?
The merit report. Well, I would say that according to the merit report, that they're very skeptical. Although it probably is true you can fall in love at first, but I think the merit report, as I remember, said it was they were skeptical.
Do you know what the merit report is?
Oh, John, doesn't everybody?
Joe Merritt.
Gallagher.
I don't. I just read the question.
Gallagher knows.
He didn't read the merit report. He can't even read.
No, hey, John. No. The merit report is what Miss Landers used to give us gold stars for.
That's
that
right.
Was the merit report.
And that's
you
it.
Okay, Cindy, according to the Cleaver report, Beaver says that the merit report says that most American men are skeptical about love at first sight. Agree or disagree for the first square?
I agree.
They believe you can fall in love at first sight. You should have disagreed with the bead, and your opponent gets the first square and $25. Okay, Debbie Sullivan, an immediate break for you. Pick a star.
Richard, please.
Yes, ma'am.
Rich Carell.
Yeah.
What are there more of in the United States? Nuclear reactors or 4-star generals?
What are there more of? 4-star generals or nuclear reactors? I'll say there's more nuclear reactors.
Agree or disagree, Debbie?
I'll agree.
There are more nuclear reactors. You are right to agree, and you get a second over. There are 81 reactors and only 27 4-star generals. Okay, Cindy Charbonneau, pick a star for me where you'd like to put your ex.
Gene to block, please.
Gene, pay attention.
Gene who? Is he here?
Okay, you get this one. You do block. However, if you miss this one, Debbie, the challenger, has a clean sweep and wins the first game. Gene, the Pentagon recently designed something special for women soldiers. Is it maternity clothes for pregnant Marines or bulletproof bras?
In either case, I did not go near the women's barracks. You can't accuse me of anything.
Yes, sir.
What did you say, bulletproof bras?
I sure said it.
Bulletproof bras to protect the...
the Marine.
Stop right there, Gene.
Or... Well, what was the other one?
Maternity clothes for pregnant Marines.
Well, I believe since the pregnancy issue has been tested in the courts among female military personnel... the military lost. They are no longer able to eliminate women who become pregnant. They must keep them.
Wake up!
It's been a long 20 years, huh, Mr. Rutherford? Yes, G.
I believe that it has to do with the designing the maternity clothes.
Okay, Gene says that maternity clothes for pregnant Marines is what the Pentagon has recently designed for women soldiers. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
Maternity clothes for pregnant Marines it is. You're right to agree. You do get the square and the block. Okay, your X goes up, and it's back to you, Debbie.
Okay, Mr. Rutherford.
Mr. Rutherford. Otherwise known as Richard.
A.K.A.
Yes, A.K.A. Richard.
What does that mean?
Are you wet now? That means also known as Mr. Rutherford.
Thank you so much.
It's been invented since 1963. Who's taller? The average emperor penguin or the average nun?
What?
It says here, who's taller, the average emperor penguin or the average nun?
The average nun, there's no question.
Agree or disagree, Debbie?
I'll agree.
The average nun it is. You're right, you agree, and you get the scare. The average emperor penguin stands about 3.5 feet tall. Doesn't say how tall the average nun is. Okay, Cindy, your move. Where would you like to put your ex?
Eddie to block, please.
Right.
Hi, Cindy.
Hi, Eddie.
You missed this one. Debbie takes the first game.
Make it an animal question, okay? You know I'm good at those.
Eddie Haskell, on any given day in America, are there more mailmen bitten by dogs, or are there more people donating blood?
Oh. That's not really has much to do with animals, actually.
You just said animals. You don't know who's giving the blood.
Probably the mailmen are giving the blood to the dogs. I would say more people donating blood. There's an awful lot of people giving blood. I would say blood.
Agree or disagree, there are more people donating blood to block.
Absolutely.
I disagree.
There are more people donating blood. No, you should have agreed with Eddie Haskell. Your opponent
Cindy,
gets the square and wins the first
me,
game.
Okay?
Each day, only 45 mailmen are bitten around America. Who compiles these statistics? Okay, you're off to a good start, Debbie, but we will be back to play a $200 game right after this. Do not despair.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour.
The following message.
Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
$200 over here for Debbie and $25 over here for Cindy. Those numbers are significant because our next game is worth $200 and $25 once again for every square that you capture. Last game was won by Debbie. That means Cindy gets to start this one. Pick a star.
Beaver, please.
The Beaver
we'll
again.
We'll do better this
the
time. Bee.
Hey, John.
Yes,
don't
Eddie?
Don't give any hard questions to the kid, huh?
Try this one, Beef.
I'll try.
Victoria Principal claims that this is the best way to do the exercises in her new book. Should you wear a Victoria Principal extra suit, or should you be completely naked?
Remember
carefully,
now, Victoria.
Yes.
Victoria's problems.
I would say she used to be an agent. She's probably a pretty good businesswoman. I'd say she'd want them in the suits.
Agree or disagree? You should wear a Victoria Principal extra suit, Cindy.
I agree.
You should be completely naked. No, you should have disagreed, and your opponent gets that square.
Where is her class, John? Where did she conduct her classes?
We'll go together, Gene.
Okay.
Okay, Debbie, pick a star for me.
Richard, please.
All right. Rich Carell.
Ready.
Alias Richard.
Right.
Whose last words were, "I have a terrific headache"? Was it Franklin D. Roosevelt or Marie Antoinette?
It was my wife.
Not tonight, dear.
Well, I don't think it was Marie, so I'll have to go with Franklin. I think that's what he said. Roosevelt said that.
Agree or disagree that those were Franklin Roosevelt's last words, Debbie?
I'll agree.
Franklin D. Roosevelt it was. Yes,
see,
you're right to agree, and you get the square. Yes, see, Richard. A footnote.
If Marie had said that, she would have said it in French. So that's how you know that Roosevelt was the one that said it. She wouldn't have said it that way.
Cindy, pick a star for me. Where you'd like to put your ex?
Jean to block, please.
Right. You miss this one, she takes yet another game, and then you could be in trouble. Okay, Gene Rayburn.
Ready.
You're in Japan.
Yeah.
You've taken the traditional 3 sips of sake. Have you just gotten married, or are you about to commit Harry Carey?
Either way.
I have had a long, happy marriage. Speak for yourself.
Oh, sorry, I'm single.
Mr. Rutherford, I suppose this is something that one would have to have some Oriental background to really have any knowledge about, and
should I ask somebody else?
Ask somebody else.
Definitely.
I would,
you know,
here's the way I would figure it out. If I were going to do harakiri, as we say in Japan,
ooh,
I would take the 3 belts of booze, which is what sake is. It's rice wine of a very high alcoholic content, and that would act as a anesthetic. So that when you do this and then carve it out as the
Oh!
Well, listen, at least you kept Rutherford awake this time. You're doing okay.
I'd say the sake.
Yeah, no, the sake.
Sake is not the question.
Yeah, I'd say, give me the three sake belts of to sake. Me.
Yeah, the sake's in here. It's whether you're getting married after you take it,
no,
or you're about to commit.
Oh,
the harakiri.
Right.
Gotcha. Okay, he says if you take these three traditional sips of sake, you are about to commit harakiri. To stop yourself from committing harakiri and block, do you agree or disagree?
I disagree.
You have just gotten married. You are right to disagree. You get the square and you do it.
Oh,
okay, good play. Debbie Sullivan, she has found new life. Now you must place another O.
Mr. Rutherford, I can't say that.
I can't either. Call me Richard.
Okay.
Richard Deacon, which came first, Campbell's pork and beans or the Richter scale?
See the connection there?
I see it, yeah.
It was easy with the nuns and the emperor penguins, black and white. You got that, didn't you?
Oh, shut up. Which came first? Which came first, the penguins or Campbell's soup?
Campbell's pork and beans or the Richter scale?
As a former chef, Campbell's been around a long time. Mr. Richter just made it a few years ago when, you know, things got tough out here. So I would say the Campbell's soup.
Agree or disagree that Campbell's pork and beans, he says, came before the Richter scale, Debbie?
I'll agree.
Campbell's pork and beans it is. You're right to agree, and you get the square. And O goes up. Cindy Charbonneau, does she have you by the O's? Pick a star.
Eddie DeBlock, please.
Eddie Haskell. In inches, what is the size of the average American woman's bra?
Don't look at me. Take it away.
Go for it.
Don't look at me.
Next question, please.
You're stuck with this one.
Well, I've been married a long time, so I would say 34.
Cindy, he says the size of the average American woman's bra is 34. To block, do you agree or disagree?
I agree.
34 it is. Whoa. You're right. You get the square and you do block.
Cindy, you're lucky because I was guessing.
Some suspense. Okay, Debbie Sullivan, she thwarted you there. Pick a star for me.
June to win, please.
Right, she didn't thwart you here. You can win the game with this one for Barbara Billingsley. You've been admitted to a hospital. According to a government study, are you more likely there because you had an accident or because you're having a baby?
Accidents, babies. Now or a few years ago, there's a boom on, isn't there? I'll say an accident. I think it has to be an accident.
She says you're more likely in a hospital because you're having an accident. For the game, agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
It is because you're having a baby. That's more likely. Your opponent gets
it
that
could be
square.
A baby by accident.
Okay, the tables have turned just a little bit, and we will see how this pretty thrilling game comes out right after these messages. Be sure to come back too. I know you will.
This is not a radish.
.org now.
275 for Debbie Sullivan and 100 for Cindy Charbonneau so far, but the worm has slightly turned in this game. Cindy, it is your move. Tell me where you'd like to put an X.
Gallagher to win, please.
Oh, to win. Oh, this is some pressure.
Gallagher Cleaver, yes.
Okay.
Phil Donahue recently had to apologize to an entire city after insulting it on his television show.
Uh-huh.
Which city did Phil insult?
All of them.
I'll give you some choices.
Continue to until they get the show off the network. What is it?
I'll give you some choices. Newark, Pittsburgh, Cleveland, or Burbank?
Well, boy, that sounds like one town, doesn't it? I think that he insulted Cleveland. He said it sounded like a town built between two breasts.
Okay, the actual insult doesn't count here, you realize. It's just the name of the
city. Well, I had too much information, but I'm up on it. I saw his shows.
Gallagher says that Phil Donahue insulted Cleveland, right? Now, for the game, agree or disagree, Cindy?
Could I hear the choices again?
Newark, Pittsburgh, Cleveland, or Burbank?
I disagree.
Newark, it was. You're right to disagree. You get the square and you win the game. What does he know? Okay, congratulations, defending champion. You have won the game. You have 325 to 275. It's still a very, very close contest. We're going to clear the board and move right on to the next game. And this one is going to be worth $300. The last one was won by Cindy. Debbie, you get to start this one. It's very close, and every $25 counts, every square. Pick a star for me.
Richard, please.
Richard Carell.
Yes.
Which came first, the first supermarket or Luciano Pavarotti?
Another close comparison, you know what I'm saying? I would say Luciano came first.
Agree or disagree, Debbie?
I'll agree.
The first supermarket came first. You should have disagreed in this case, and Cindy gets that square, and X goes up. Cindy, you're playing X, pick a star.
Beaver again.
See if I can get one right, finally.
Jerry Mathers, you're a beaver.
Possible. Ah.
And you're slapping your tail on the surface of the water.
I do that all the time in the pool.
Are you warning other beavers of danger, or are you trying to attract a mate?
No, beavers do that only when there's danger. They always put a scout up so that they know if their dam's going to be broken or not. I've got that one. No problem.
Agree or disagree, Cindy, that they're trying to warn other beavers of danger?
I agree.
They are warning other beavers of danger. You are right to agree, and you get another square. And that bell, the time is up with $375. Once again, fourth time in a row, she is our winner, Cindy Chardonneau. She just goes, you know. And we're just standing here playing the game. See, this is where I'm supposed to say, go over there and join Gene Rayburn, get sent for your shot at the big money, but she just goes by herself now. So instead, I think that I will say goodbye to you. She is a tough player.
Yeah.
I mean, we have to finally admit it. It's $275 for you, but she had $375. She has done it again, but you were terrific. Thanks for playing Match Game Hollywood Squares. Okay, once again, over to Gene Rayburn.
Okay, John, here we are once again. Congratulations to the champ. We'll be back in a moment with our nine stars here and the big money right after this.
Answer. Your gift shows you care.
Now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Okay, Gene Moore, here we go. Now, this woman has $34,850. The question is, will she win more, and how much more? She could win up to $30,000 more, shall we?
Oh, yes.
Okay. Here it is. We polled the studio audience not too long ago, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Blank chomp. Remember, if you get the $1,000 answer, and the $500 answer, they're second most popular. The third most popular gives you $250. Now, three of any of the six loonies here can assist you in suggesting answers. Who is loony number one you're going to call on?
Lumpy.
Lumpy loony.
There is no doubt about it. Lamb chop.
Lamb chop. All right, there's one.
John.
Pork chop.
You say pork chop?
I sure do.
Okay, John.
And Judy.
Hi, Judy.
All the chops are taken.
No.
Well, Richard or June may give you one. There's another one.
How about a karate chop?
A karate chop. Yeah. Okay, so you have karate chop, lamb chop, and pork chop. You may choose one of those, or perhaps you'd like to think up one of your own. What is your pleasure here?
Pork chop.
Pork chop it is?
Yeah. Good answer.
All right, that's the answer that John Bauman gave you. We'll find out if it's up there. And if so, in what position? Is it under the $250 response? No. Judy's answer is there. Is it under the $500 response?
Uh-oh.
No. Is it under the $1,000 response? Yes! Yes, sirree! Wowee! You got it!
Forgive me, Mom, I said pork, but she won. It's okay. It's good.
All right.
I didn't mean to say pork.
Another $1,000. You're up to $35,850. Now you're going to play the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing here. And remember, each star has a number, a 10, a 20, or 30. And you're going to choose a star, and that star will reveal the number, and then we will multiply your $1,000 by the secret hidden number. Time to choose a star.
Beaver, please.
All right, Beaver, take that tab and give it a yank. Go! A 10, so you're playing for $10,000.
There it is.
Come on, Beaver.
Here we go.
Come on, Beaver.
All right. If you get this right, you'll be up to over 44,000. Good luck to you, Cindy. Here it is. Ready, Beav?
I'm ready.
Open blank. O-P-E-N. Open blank. Or open blank. Put it in the slot when you're ready. Okay, he did. Now it's up to you, Cindy, for $10,000. You want to match the Beaver to collect the money. How do you do that? Open blank.
Sesame.
Open sesame. Yeah. What do you say, Beav?
I said open door. I was...
Open door.
Hey, open door policy.
Cindy, I'm going to tell Wally on him. He'll take care of him.
What'd you say, Eddie?
I'm going to tell Wally on him. He'll take care of him.
Okay.
Give him the business.
So we'll get Wally. Where is Wally?
I don't know where he is right now.
Where is he, Gallagher?
Just got back from Japan.
Japan?
Mom says Japan.
Couldn't be here today because he just got back from Japan. Okay. Now, Cindy, you got $35,850, and we'll be back in a moment or so right after these messages.
You want to be a...
Okay, now we want to reveal... The other cards that have not been revealed. John, would you take a seat there? Everybody grab the tab. Ready, set, go, pull. Judy had the big 3-0. And Eddie broke his. All right.
You'll pay for that,
Gene Rayburn here saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares
and
Hour.
And John Bowman saying see y'all tomorrow.
Our studio audience will receive Hitachi's cassette match music system, FM AM stereo receiver with 7.5 watts per channel, belt drive turntable with magnetic cartridge, two-way high drone cone speaker system furnished by Hitachi. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson, Television Production.